don't ever recall having an opportunity to offer a mayor of the quality of Magical World and her offspring of the quality of Garana. It's a kind of once in a lifetime opportunity for Fasig Tipton. Both mayors are obviously highly desirable, collector's items in their own right. Both mayors are in foal to end the mischief. So you've got an amazing pedigree with really unlimited potential to continue to develop.
Magical World's obviously one of those foundational mayors. Out of Pleasant Home, Breeders' Cup Distaff winner. You look at that pedigree, there's so many great runners in there.
She's a mayor with her entire future in front of her. She's the kind of mayor to be Brood Mayor of the Year. So I think the future is immensely bold for this entire family.
She's produced two top race horses, both TD and Rising Stars, within about 2 months of each other. Garana has just been brilliant virtually every day that she was on the racetrack. Magic Dance was a very, very, very precocious filly and demonstrated great potential. You also throw in the sales history. She's produced a $2.1 million sales yearling.
I mean, I think she produces great physicals because she is a great physical. She's got the speed of Distorted Humor in there, but a lot of scope and stretch that came from the dam side. And she just reproduces again and again. Garana was a very athletic, strong filly that was sort of a barn favorite. I would come every month or so and look at her. You just, oh, she got better and better and better. But once she got to the track, I mean, it was lights out. Chad loved her. She won by 16 first out, second start, win the Acorn in record time. It doesn't really get better than that.
They're off for the Acorn.
I think the Acorn, I mean, anybody that watches Garana's Acorn, that's one of those races where you say, did I really just see that? The brilliance in which she demonstrated was remarkable.
But it's Garana on to another impressive outing here. Garana 2 for 2, and she's an Acorn winner. She won it by 5 over Serengeti Empress. And then it was.
She's also demonstrated her versatility as far as a racehorse. You know, she's won grade ones at 7, 8, 9 furlongs. So it wasn't like she was one-dimensional. She literally could do it all.
Off the layoff, she won the grade one here at Keeneland.
And Garana, what a battle in the grade one, Madison. Garana fighting back and fighting
just
back.
Just a phenomenal race filly of world-class talent, beautifully bred, very deep Phipps pedigree. I think she lacks nothing. She's in foal to the leading sire. She's carrying her first foal. So sky's the limit. She's carrying a colt, big, beautiful mare, unique, brilliant talent. Depth of pedigree that traces back to Maple Jinsky and some very influential major dirt pedigrees of the last 20 years, 30 years here in America. So really all the tools you'd look for, I think she has them all in spades.
It's hard to find that kind of mare. She's definitely special to Three Chimneys and obviously was so special for John to join in and want to be partners on her.
There's no question that Magical World and Garana offer the potential to be, breed-changing opportunities wherever the owner happens to decide to race the offspring. Potential is unlimited for both these mares. And you think of the youth of this pedigree and the future that it might have, it's remarkable and really a very, very, very rare situation.